Greetings and welcome to lecture series on thermodynamics. This is module 1, lecture number 9. So today's topics will be minus integral VDP work, comparison between PdV and VDP work, numericals, few numericals on open system, meaning of free expansion, perpetual motion machine 1, and difference between heat and internal energy. So this will complete the module number 1. So we'll start with minus VDP work. So we have already seen, let me write down the equation. We have already seen integral PdV. It is also known as PdV work. Now we will see minus integral VDP work. This is for closed system PdV work, and minus integral VDP work, it is for open system. So we will see how this equation minus integral VDP comes. So for that there is a small derivation. So for closed system, if you consider, what is the formula of first law of thermodynamics for a process? Delta U, this is small u, so it will be specific internal energy. Delta U is equal to specific heat, small q minus specific work, small w. So delta U equal to q minus w. In differential form, what you can write? Du. Why d? Because internal energy is property of a system and exact differential, that is why du. Equal to heat and work are path function in exact differential, that is why it is delta. Equal to delta q minus delta w. Now what we will do, delta q, take du on this side, so it will become minus du equal to delta w. Now what is delta w for closed system? It is PdV. So we will get this equation, delta q minus du equal to PdV. Now our concern is we have to develop this equation for open system, what is work? Minus integral VDP. So for open system, what is the formula of first law? We have already seen in formula list, we have two formulas, steady flow energy equation on time basis and steady flow energy equation on mass basis. We will use this equation. In this equation, only thing is instead of delta H, we will write similar to this one, delta U plus delta flow work. Okay, so we will take this equation now for the derivation part. So Q minus, this is small, why? Because this is mass basis. So Q minus shaft work equal to change in kinetic energy plus change in potential energy plus change in internal energy plus change in flow work. Now next, what is done? Differentiate this equation. So what you will get, this dq, this q will become delta q. This shaft work which is there, it is negative, even though here it is negative, it is actually positive. Okay, why? We have already seen in derivation. So this is taken on right hand side, so it becomes positive and it will be delta. Why? Because it work is path function, so it is taken towards right. Now next term, delta U, this is property of system, so it will become du. It is taken on left hand side, so it will become negative. Remaining part is as it is. So remaining part is change in kinetic energy is written as dke, change in potential energy is written as dpe, and what is flow work? Flow work, this is specific flow work, change in specific flow work. So it will be delta of pressure into specific volume. Now, if you differentiate this, what you will get? You will get this term. So differentiation of PV will be equal to PdV plus VDP. Okay. So again, I'll repeat this part. So Q will be path function, that is why delta Q. Then delta u, if it is differentiated, we will get du, take on left hand side, it will become negative. Shaft work we are taking on right hand side, and it is path function, that is why delta shaft work. Change in kinetic energy, change in potential energy will remain as it is, and flow work, which is P into specific flow work, is P into specific volume, that will be PdV plus VdV. Now next. Now you can see this equation and this equation. What is common? Left hand side is common. Okay, so you can see this part and this part is same. So you can equate these two equations. So for same heat transfer and change in internal energy, that is change in temperature. Why? Because internal energy depends on temperature. So what we will get? PdV is equal to this part of the equation, right side. dKe plus dPe plus PdV plus VdP plus delta shaft work. Now change in now this PdV is common on both the sides, so we will cancel this. So PdV is cancelled. And what we require, we are doing derivation for minus integral VdP. So what we will do, we will take this VdP on left side. So what we will get? Minus VdP. So minus VdP equal to dKe plus dPe plus delta shaft work. Now in most of the engineering devices, change in potential energy is zero. That is why we will cancel this part. So what we will get? Minus integral and then integrate it. So what we will get? Minus integral VdP equal to change in kinetic energy plus shaft work. Why? Because in most of the engineering devices, change in potential energy is zero. So here we have assumed that. Now this is the main equation. Now for nozzle, we have seen in case of nozzle there is no shaft work. Nozzle doesn't give work, that is why shaft work is zero. So what you will get? Change in kinetic energy is minus integral VdP. Now compare this equation with the equation which we had already derived. Change in kinetic energy is equal to minus delta H. This we got. Okay, now similarly, what we got? Change in kinetic energy is equal to minus integral VdP. Okay, both equations have same meaning. Now for turbine and compressor, change in kinetic energy is zero. So in this equation, change in kinetic energy will be zero. So what we will get? Shaft work is minus integral VdP. Now I'll show you the example of turbine over here. What equation we got in turbine? See, this is turbine. Shaft work is H1 minus H2 for turbine, and for compressor it is H2 minus H1. Okay, so for turbine it is H1 minus H2, for compressor it is H2 minus H1. And similarly, shaft work is also equal to minus integral VdP. Now what is the difference between PdV and minus integral VdP? PdV and VdP is, PdV is area under PV diagram, it is below the PV diagram. Okay, and VdP, it is area towards left of the PV diagram. So this we will again go through some presentation part to understand the difference between PdV and VdP. So see this PV diagram. If you see the PV diagram, this is for closed system where we use PdV. In that case, area under PV diagram is work done. So work done for non-flow process. Non-flow means closed system process. Now if you consider open system, for open system process, we consider work done formula as minus integral VdP. So it is area towards left side of this curve. Okay, this is the difference. Now since work done is integral PdV for closed system, and for open system it is minus integral VdP, we will have different sets of formulas for closed system and open system. Now we will be deriving those formulas. Okay, so for closed system, these are the formulas which we had already derived, and for open system, these are the formulas. We will derive these formulas now. So we'll go through the derivation part now. Yes. Okay, okay. So in case of closed system, in case of closed system, where only we have mass transfer, we don't have mass transfer in closed system, we only have energy transfer. In that case, area under PV diagram is work done. But when you consider open system like nozzle, diffuser, turbine, compressor, boiler, heat exchanger, throttling, in that case work done is minus integral VDP, that is area towards left of PV diagram. This is the difference between them. And now already we have derived equations for PDV, integral PDV work. Now we will derive equations for different processes like constant volume, constant pressure, isothermal, adiabatic and polytropic for minus integral VDP. So here heading is given work interaction of steady flow system for various thermodynamic processes. First process, constant volume. So PV diagram we have drawn, constant volume means it will be vertical line. Now if you see work done for closed system, for constant volume it was zero. Why? Because it was, what was the equation? Let me quickly write down the equation. It was integral PdV. And for constant volume, this dV is zero. That is why work done was zero. But in this case, it is minus integral VdP. That is why V is common and here we have pressure change. So equation we will get as V P1 minus P2. Next process, constant pressure. Now what is the formula? Minus integral VDP. Now DP is zero. That is why shaft work is zero. And this is the case in boiler and condenser. If you see boiler and condenser, steady flow energy equation, what we had? Only we had heat transfer, which was dependent on enthalpy for boiler and condenser. Okay, why? Because their shaft work is zero. In this way, we can prove that in boiler and condenser, shaft work is zero. So, next one, isothermal process. For isothermal process, again, we will have shaft work is equal to minus integral VDP. Now, what is the law for isothermal process? Isothermal means constant temperature. PV equal to constant, so it will be P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. Now, from this equation, first equation, what we will get? Specific volume is equal to C upon pressure. So instead of specific volume, we will substitute that value. Okay, see this part. V is C upon P. So instead of this V, we will write C upon P. So we'll take C common and what we will get? Integration of 1 upon x dx is log x. Okay, so we'll get, and then substitute the limits, you will get C log P1 upon P2. Now what is this C? Either P1 V1 or P2 V2 or MRT or RT1. Why? Because this is specific volume. So it will be RT1 or RT2. So same thing, P1 V1, then log P1 upon P2. Now, if you see the closed system formula and open system formula for work, both are same. Okay, both are same. That is why for isothermal process, integral PdV is equal to minus integral VdP. Only for isothermal process. So, this formula for work will be same in case of both closed system and open system. Next process, isentropic process. in case of isentropic process, for which system? Open system. Again, shaft work is equal to minus integral VdP. Now, what is the law for this isentropic process? PV raised to gamma is constant. So, what will be V? V will be equal to C raised to 1 upon gamma upon P raised to 1 upon gamma. Now, instead of C, we will write X divided by P raised to 1 upon gamma. Now, I'll mark this. So, what is C? What is this V? Instead of this V, you can write X upon P raised to 1 upon gamma. Same thing I have done over here. It is written over here and X is taken common. Why? Because it is constant. So, X is taken out of the integration. So, minus X integral 1 to 2, 1 upon P raised to 1 by gamma dP. Integrate this. Now, take this in the numerator. What you will get? P raised to minus 1 upon gamma. Now, integrate that and apply the limit. So, what will be integration? P raised to minus 1 upon gamma plus 1 upon minus 1 upon gamma plus 1. Apply the limits. So, what we will do? This will become gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So, we will take it outside the bracket. So, here we will get minus X. This part will remain as it is. And gamma upon gamma minus 1. In bracket, we will have P raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma P2 and minus P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Next part. Okay. Next part now we will see. So, next part, this part is a bit tricky part. Okay. Now, here you can see in this equation, gamma upon gamma minus 1 is kept outside the bracket. Okay. And this minus sign is taken inside. So, instead of P2 minus P1, P2 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, we will have P1 minus P2 inside. Okay. This one. And this is separated. So, we will get gamma upon gamma will be 1. So, we will get P1 and the remaining part is P1 raised to 1 minus gamma. And here also we will get P2 and P2 raised to minus 1 upon gamma. Now, what is this X? This X will be V multiplied. So this X will be equal to specific volume multiplied by P raised to 1 by gamma. This is gamma. So instead of that, we will multiply, but for point 1, we will multiply by, this will be P1 V1. Okay, V1 into P1. So V1 P1 raised to 1 by gamma, and here we will take V2 P2 raised to 1 by gamma. Then you can see this and this will be cancelled, and similarly this part and this part will be cancelled. So what you will get, this gamma is kept outside, this gamma, and inside the bracket we will have P1 V1. Okay, this V1 is there and this P1 is there. So P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon gamma minus 1. Now this formula, this part of the formula is similar to closed system. That is why what we can write now, what conclusion we can write from this is, for open system isentropic process, work done formula is gamma multiplied by closed system work done formula. So what is this equation? Minus integral VdP is equal to gamma times of integral PdV for isentropic process. Now, what is this VdP, minus integral VdP? It is work done for steady flow process. This is equal to gamma times of work done for non-flow process, that is closed system. This is the equation which we get. Similarly, we are not doing derivation for polytropic process, what we will get final result will be work done for steady flow process is n instead of gamma, here we will have n. N multiplied by work done for closed system. Okay, this will be similar result. You can try on your own. Now we'll see the comparison between closed system and open system formulas in this slide. Okay, so understand this table, very important table. Okay, we will require this table in gas power cycles. Okay, there I will be asking you one question. That question answer you will get from this table. Okay, so what is this? First column is process, constant volume, constant pressure, isothermal, polytropic and adiabatic. And first column is for closed system, second column is for open system work. Now here you can see non-flow means closed system and steady flow means open system. Okay, remember this. Now for this formula we have already derived for so I have written it as it is, and steady flow also we have derived, so they are also listed over here. Now we'll see the difference. For constant volume, closed system work done is zero, but open system we have this formula. For constant pressure, work done for closed system we have this formula, but integral VDP in this part DP is zero. That is why work done for constant pressure during open system is zero. So this you can see, it is in a cross way. So for closed system, work done in constant volume is zero. For open system, work done in constant pressure is zero. Okay, next. For isothermal process, you can see this part. Work done for closed system and work done for open system, both are same. That is why we can conclude that integral PdV is equal to integral V minus VdP for isothermal process. Next, polytropic process. Here you can see for polytropic process, both the formulas are same except here N is multiplied. So what you can say, for steady flow process, what is formula of work done for polytropic process? N multiplied by work done for polytropic process during in closed system. The formula is same except you have to just multiply N over here. Similarly, for adiabatic process, formula remains same. Only change in steady flow or open system is we have to multiply by gamma. So this formula will be gamma for open system work done for isentropic process. It will be gamma multiplied by work done for closed system for isentropic process. Everyone understood this part, this table. Difference between closed system and open system work done, formulas will be different. This is based on integral PdV and this is based on minus integral VdP. Okay. Now based on this concept, we will see some numerical. So let me clear my screen. Okay, this question is very tricky question, so understand it properly. So we'll see the question and write the given data from the question. This question is from December 17, 2A. It has been asked for 10 marks. I am reading the question simultaneously. We will see the diagram and we'll write the given data on the diagram itself. A reciprocating air compressor takes in 2 meter cube per minute at 0.11 megapascal, 20 degree Celsius. So here, instead of this, I have shown over here rotary compressor. Instead of this, we will have a piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, it doesn't matter much, but instead of this arrangement we will have piston cylinder arrangement. Okay. Now next thing is, compressor is which type of device? Power consuming device. Remember this. That is why shaft work is consumed by the compressor. So we have drawn the compressor. This is point 1. This is point 2 for the compressor. What data is given? 2 meter cube per minute means V dot 1. V dot 1 is 2 meter cube per minute. We have to write the data. P1. What is P1? 0.11 megapascal. How to convert this in kilopascal? Multiply by 1000 into 10 raised to 3. What is T1? 20 plus 273, 293 Kelvin. So a reciprocating compressor takes in at this condition, which delivers at 1.5 megapascal. So P2 is 1.5 megapascal and T2 is 111 degree Celsius equal to 384 Kelvin. To an after cooler. So this compressed air is supplied to after cooler, where air is cooled at constant pressure. So inside this after, what is this device? After cooler is constant pressure device. Remember, this is very important. Constant pressure device. 225 degree Celsius. So at the exit of cooler, this T3 temperature is how much? 25 degree Celsius. So 25 plus 273, that will be the temperature. The power absorbed by the compressor is 4.15 kilowatt. Now this is power absorbed. Remember, work is done on the control volume. That is why this work should be positive or negative? Negative. This work will be negative. Why? Because this is compressor, power consuming device. So work will be negative. So here you can see in steady flow equation, this work we have taken as negative. This is very important part. Next, what we have to determine? Determine the heat transfer in the compressor. Now there will be one question. If you see the derivation which we had done initially, what we had assumed for compressor, it is adiabatic, like heat transfer is zero in compressor. We will see that part. Okay, see this. When we had studied the compressor part, what we had done, heat transfer was taken as zero. But in our numerical, remember, we cannot use this equation directly. We have to derive. Okay, it is specifically asked that heat is transferred from the compressor. So there is no insulation in case of our compressor in the given question. So don't get confused in this equation and our numerical. So in our numerical, we have heat transfer. So heat is rejected. Heat is rejected by the compressor. So answer of this should be negative. Here you can see answer is negative. Okay, if this answer you get positive, means somewhere you have made mistake. So for in our case, since work is supplied to the compressor, it is negative, it is taken as negative, and heat is rejected from the compressor, so that value also comes out to be negative. What is the second part of the question? Determine heat transfer from after cooler also. So Q dot cooler also we have to calculate. Okay, now I'll close the question part. We'll go to the solution. Now what we will do is apply steady flow energy equation to compressor. Apply steady flow energy equation to compressor on time basis. What we will get? Q dot minus W dot shaft equal to M dot in bracket change in kinetic energy plus change in potential energy plus change in enthalpy. Now in this equation, heat transfer value is asked, Q dot C is asked from the compressor. So we will keep it as it is. Don't cancel this. Minus, what is work done? Since it is supplied, it will be negative. So minus, see the unit. Okay, this is kilowatt. That is why we are using W dot. So this will be minus 4.15, bracket complete, equal to M dot. Now M dot value is not known over here. Okay, mass flow rate value is not known. This is unknown. So I'll put a question mark over here. Okay, I'll put a question mark over here. Change in kinetic energy, change in potential energy, nothing is given in question. We will assume it to be zero. Plus change in enthalpy. Okay, don't cancel this change in enthalpy. Now, what we can do is, for point number 1, we can apply this ideal gas law equation, equation P1 V dot 1 equal to M dot 1 R T1. P1 value, what is P1? 0.1 megapascal. We have to substitute in kilopascal. So 0.11 into 10 raised to 3 into what is the specific volume given here for point 1? 2 meter cube per minute. But this V dot 1 is meter cube per second. This is meter cube per second. That is why divide by 60. So 2 by 60 equal to M dot 1. Okay. Now M dot 1 or M dot 2, it doesn't matter. Why? Because in assumption itself, we had seen mass flow rate throughout the system remains constant. So whether we write M dot 1 or we write M dot 2, it will remain same. That is why I have taken only M dot. Multiplied by what is the flowing medium air. That is why R value is 0.287 into temperature 1 in Kelvin is 293. So we will get M dot 1, this value. Substitute M dot 1 value over here. Now change in enthalpy. Write down somewhere in your notebook, top side of your notebook, enthalpy formula for ideal gas is Cp. This is specific enthalpy, remember, specific enthalpy Cp into T, and this T is in degree Celsius. Okay, it is not in Kelvin. Very important. Write down this formula somewhere. For ideal gas, okay, this is for ideal gas only, like air. Ideal gas. And how this is true, I will show you with some example in the next numerical. How this is true, we will see by some example in next numerical. So, enthalpy is Cp into T, but T is in degree Celsius. And this is which type of enthalpy? Specific enthalpy. What will be unit of this? Kilojoule per kg. This formula, write it down somewhere. Now, we have to use the same formula in our case. So, H1 will be Cp into T1. So, Cp for air is 1.005 and T1, remember, this should be in degree Celsius. It is 20. So, you will get H1 value. Similarly, what will be H2? H2 will be Cp into T2. So, Cp is 1.005 and what is T2? In degree Celsius, 111. So, 111. So, we will get H2. Substitute these values in this equation. Okay, H2 minus H1. The only unknown in this equation is what? What is the only unknown in this equation? Q dot C. Heat rejected by the compressor. So, we have completed the first part of the question. What is the second part of the question? Q dot C. Now, already in this, what is given in the question? The process is constant process, constant pressure process. So, we have seen the formula. What is heat transfer in case of constant pressure process? Refer the formula list which we have already derived for heat transfer. It is MCP delta T. So, method 2 we will see afterwards. Okay. This is, see, this Q dot C I have calculated using one method. There is one more method. It is a bit advanced method. Using that also we can calculate Q dot C. This we will see afterwards. Now first we will see Q dot for after cooler. So this method we will see afterwards. So what is this Q dot for cooler? Since it is constant pressure process, it will be M dot Cp into delta T. What is M dot? We have already calculated 0.0436. So 0.0436. Cp for air is 1.005 and temperature difference will be T2 minus higher temperature. This will be temperature difference. Okay. So temperature difference will be 25 T3 minus T2. So 25 minus 111. So using this, what answer you will get? Q dot answer is minus 3.76 kilowatt. Now here also you can see heat is negative. What this negative sign indicates? heat is lost to the surrounding. And same question is asked, right? We'll see the question. What is the question asked over here? Determine heat transfer in compressor and after cooler. So heat is lost. Heat is lost from the compressor. Heat is lost from the after cooler. That is why both the heat, Q dot of compressor as well as Q dot of after cooler, are negative. Now we'll see the second method. Second method is a bit tricky to understand. Okay, I'll explain this. If you don't understand, you can later on see it, pause the video and see it again. Okay, so we'll solve this question instead of steady flow energy equation. Instead of this, we will solve it by minus integral VdP concept. Okay, now in this concept, minus integral VdP, what is work done formula for isentropic process? We'll see that. What is work done formula for isentropic process? See, what is work done formula for isentropic process? Gamma P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon gamma minus 1. So this formula for isentropic process we have to use. Now why isentropic process? See, in case of compressor, this concept you have not studied. That is why I told it is bit tricky to understand. Okay, so this is a concept which you will study in module number 2. Work done is minimum in isentropic process. Okay, this concept we will see in module number 2. That is why for compressor, we have to write formula of open system for isentropic work. Now what is that? Minus integral VdP is gamma P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon gamma minus 1. So that formula we have to write over here. Okay, so we'll see this. So instead of N, this is a mistake. Instead of N, we have to write, there will be a change in formula over here. Okay, there will be a change in formula. Instead of N, what I will write? This will be gamma upon gamma minus 1. Why we are using this formula for work done is because there is a concept which we will see in module number 2. Work done is minimum in case of isentropic process. That is why minus integral VdP formula we are using for open system. Remember, this is open system. Why? Because compressor is open system, but for isentropic process. Now using this, we'll substitute the value and we'll get the answer of compressor work as this one. Okay, gamma for air is 1.4 and we will get this one. Okay, but see the diagram now. See the diagram. What do you mean by word isentropic? Heat transfer is zero. But in question, what is given? We have some heat transfer. Okay, we have some heat transfer. It is given in question. So, ideally speaking, what should be the work supplied? Minimum work, it is minus 3.9854 kilowatt. But what work we are supplying? We are supplying 4.15, minus 4.15. So it is excess compared to 3 point. So where will this extra work go? It is generated into heat. Okay, that is why work supplied, which is minus 4.15, and ideal work required, which is minus 3.9854, when we add this together, what we get is some extra part. That part is rejected to the surrounding. Okay, that is why I told this concept is a bit difficult to understand. So here you can see what will be Q dot C, same formula. Q dot C will be heat given in the question, work given in the question. See, now here this is work and we are considering that work while calculating heat. Why? Because I'll tell you the reason. Heat is equal to whatever work is supplied over here and whatever is the ideal work, which is 3.98, difference between that, this difference will be rejected as heat. Are you getting? Even though this 4.15 and this 3.9854, this is heat, this is work, but difference of these two will give us heat. Okay, so I'll repeat this part again. this method again, compressor work. Ideally, a work is maximum, work is minimum. Why? Because compressor is power consuming device. So, whenever we have power consuming device, what we want, the consumption of power should be minimum. That is why if you see this work, this is minimum as compared to 4.15. Okay, this is the concept over here. So compressor work, when it will be minimum in isentropic process. That is why for open system minus integral VDP, instead of this N upon N minus 1, we have written gamma upon gamma minus 1, P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Substitute the values, we will get compressor work. Now what is the actual work which is supplied? 4.15. What is the minimum work which is required when heat transfer is zero? That is 3.9854. So where is this extra work going? 4.15, this is extra work compared to 3.98. This is rejected from the control volume. So that is why even though here we are taking difference of work, it is getting converted into heat. Okay, this part is a tricky part. If you don't follow this, you can solve by method 1. Okay, both the methods are correct. Now we'll go to next question. Okay, what? In method 2 also we are getting, see why this happens is because, what will happen is, here also you will get negative only. Okay, this is actually negative. Why? I'll explain you. Okay, it's just the difference of formula. Technique is same. So this, what we will take is this minus, we will take this is minus 1.45. Okay, and next part will be minus of minus 3.9854. So if you see this now, this is becoming positive, but this greater sign is negative. That is why actually this heat is negative only. Okay, actually this heat is negative only, but see, if you are considering from heat side, but when I am considering from work side, I am using this positive terminology over here. See, here this is negative. See, this work is negative, but I am taking here as positive. Okay, that is why I told you this is a bit difficult concept to understand. Okay, this heat is also a negative heat. If you see this answer, now answer is same, magnitude is same. Only difference is about sign, and actually there is a sign over there. Okay, this is a bit tricky to understand. So we'll go through some different question now. So you can think about that and you'll understand a bit about this one. Okay, next question. Next question which we will see is May 19. May 19 question. Okay, so we'll have the same approach. We'll read the question and write down the given data simultaneously. Air enters a compressor, so I have drawn a compressor. It is power consuming device, so I have shown input work over here. Operating at steady state means it is open system, of 1 bar pressure, a temperature of 290 Kelvin and velocity 6 meters per second through an inlet with area of 0.1 meter square. So I will write down all this data. So for inlet, that is 0.1, P1 is 1 bar. 1 bar means 100 kilopascal. You have to multiply by 100. P1 is 290 Kelvin. I have written over here. Velocity is denoted by V bar. So V bar 1 is 6 meters per second. And area at inlet, that is 0.1, is 0.1 meter square. At exit of the compressor, pressure is 7 bar. So, P2 is 7 bar. Temperature is 450 kilopascal. So, T2 is 450 kilo, Kelvin, not kilopascal. Temperature T2 is 450 Kelvin. And velocity, so V bar 2 is 2 meters per second. Heat transfer from compressor to the surround. Again, remember this. If you see the derivation which we have done in theory part for compressor, there we had assumed that heat transfer is zero. But in numericals, we see that always there is some heat transfer. So in actual case also, there will be some heat transfer. That was theoretical derivation over there. So heat transfer from the compressor to the surrounding at a rate of 180 kilojoule per minute. Okay, see this data now. This is heat transferred from control volume to surrounding, system to surrounding. That is why this heat should be negative. That is why you can see over here I have taken minus 180 kilojoule per minute. Also, you have to convert this kilojoule per minute to kilojoule per second. So, you have to divide this minus 180 by 60. Don't forget that. Otherwise, your answer will be wrong. Now, what is the remaining part? Employing ideal gas law model, calculate power input to compressor. So, we have to calculate what is the power supply to the compressor. Okay. Now, we'll move on to the solution part. So, apply what is the assumption? Control volume is as shown in the figure. Change in potential energy, we are assuming it to be zero. And ideal gas law is, can be applied to air. Our fluid is air. Okay. Now apply steady flow energy equation to compressor or control volume. So what equation we will get? Which equation you have to write? See the formula list. We have to write time basis. Why? Because Q dot is given in the question. So Q dot minus W dot equal to M dot in bracket change in kinetic plus change in potential plus change in specific enthalpy. Now, in this equation, we'll substitute the individual values Q dot minus W dot equal to M dot. What is change in kinetic energy? See the formula list. V bar 2 square minus V bar 1 square upon 2000. Write down that formula over here. Potential energy is 0, so cancel this. And what is delta H? It is H2 minus H1. Now here, in order to calculate H2 and H1, we will see two methods. Okay, we will see two methods. First method, which we have already seen. What is that method? Using CPT method. So, what is the formula of enthalpy for ideal gas? It is Cp into temperature. This temperature is in degree Celsius. So, you can calculate H1 and H2 using that formula. Okay, now how to do that? You can substitute and calculate. Okay, so this method will be homework. You can try it on your own. Okay, we'll see some different method in this question. Okay, we'll see some different method in this question. Answers using both enthalpy method, calculation of enthalpy will be same. So what we will do is we'll see properties of air table in this case. So what is the temperature of point 1? Temperature of point 1 is 290 Kelvin. So at 290 Kelvin, we'll see properties of air. So here you can see for 290 Kelvin, what is enthalpy of air? Enthalpy of air is 290.16. Okay, here you can see enthalpy is 290.16. So here we got that value. Enthalpy is 290.16 kilojoule per kg. Similarly, at outlet, what is the temperature? 450 Kelvin. So for 450 Kelvin, what will be the enthalpy? So we'll see 450 Kelvin. So here you can see for 450 Kelvin, what is the enthalpy value? 451.8 kilojoule per kg. So 451.8. You can even calculate this by Cp into delta T, you will get same answer. Remember that. Okay, now in this equation, heat is known, this value is known, work we have to calculate, M dot we don't know, velocity is given in question, enthalpy we have just calculated. So what is required? M dot is required. Now how to calculate this M dot? Okay, now what is continuity equation? M dot is equal to area into velocity upon specific volume. This equation we had written as it is. Okay, let me show you that equation in formula list. This formula, continuity equation, m dot is equal to area into velocity upon specific volume. That equation we will use over here. So for this equation, we need to calculate what from this equation? We need to calculate m dot. Area for point 1 is given, velocity of point 1 is given. We don't have specific volume of point 1. So before calculating m dot, see, for this equation, what we have to calculate? Work done. To calculate work done, what is required? M dot. Now for m dot, this is the formula. And to calculate m dot, what is required? Specific volume. So first we will calculate specific volume of point 1. So for point 1, we'll see what is the given data. For point 1, T1 is known. Okay, so we'll use that equation. Okay, so P1 V dot 1 equal to M dot R T1. Now what I have done over here is, in this equation again M dot is unknown. That is why what I have done is P1 V dot 1 upon M dot 1 or M dot is equal to RT1. Now what is this V dot 1 upon M dot? Again, this will be specific volume only. So that is why I have written over here formula. P1, that value is given in the question. Specific volume 1, this one, equal to R for air is 0.287 into T1 in Kelvin. This is given. So we'll get specific volume of 0.1. Now in this equation, area 1, velocity at point 1 and specific volume of point 1. Specific volume we just calculated. So this is also known. Volume of point 1 is given in the question, 6 meter per second. Area is also given in question, 0.1 meter square. So we'll get what? M dot. So I'll hide this part now. So M dot we have calculated. Now in this equation, what is the value of Q? Q will be minus 180, this is kilojoule per minute, convert to kilojoule per second. So minus 180 divided by 60 minus work equal to m dot, which we have calculated 0.72 into change in kinetic energy, substitute the values, change in enthalpy, substitute the values. What you will get? Work done, value is negative. Now here itself, negative sign, what this negative sign indicates? Work done on the air. Okay, in compressor is work consuming device. That is why this work answer is negative. Okay, so this is the last question which we have solved related to steady flow energy equation. Okay, so after this, we'll see the next concept now. So we have seen this. I'll summarize again about this table. This table indicates the 5 processes, and this is closed system and this is open system, and we have formulas for closed system and open system. Okay, so in closed system, area under PV diagram is work done. For open system, area to the left side of the curve is work done, and this is area below PV curve is work done. Now we'll see next concept. Next concept is free expansion. In Indian textbooks, if you see, this process is referred as free expansion. It is also known as unrestricted expansion. And if you see foreign author textbooks, you will find the word as unrestrained expansion. Okay, so free expansion, free, unrestricted, or unrestrained expansion, meaning is same. So what is the definition of this? The expansion of gas against a vacuum is called free or unrestrained expansion. So we'll see this with some example. Okay, so first diagram, if you see, this is a container. In this container, we have a membrane or a partition. This on in this one volume itself we have a partition. In one part we have gas, in other part we have vacuum. Now this complete volume we are taking as control volume. You can see gas and vacuum. Now in this case, if we remove the partition, so some work will be required to remove the partition. So if we neglect that work, then what will happen? If this partition is removed, gas will flow from this part to vacuum part. It will rush from this side. Okay, suppose this membrane is ruptured over here. So what will happen? Gas will flow inside the vacuum like this. That is why this is known as free expansion. Expansion of gas against a vacuum. Okay, expansion of gas against vacuum. Now in this case, when the partition is removed, what will happen? Gas will expand. Okay, gas is expanding, right? It will initially, see, this is only the volume, and when partition is removed and we neglect the work of this partition, removal of partition work, then gas is expanding and occupying the whole volume. So here you will ask, we should calculate the work done. But if you see, what is the system? System boundary is over here. So gas is expanding, but the work is not crossing the boundary of the system. The work is inside the control volume itself. That is why we cannot calculate work in diagram number A. Now we will take the second case. In second case, we have same volume. We have a partition. This is a gas and this is a vacuum. But instead of this complete system, we will consider only gas as the system. Only gas as the system. Now if we remove the partition and assume the work required for removal of partition is zero, in that case again we will have expansion. And now in this case, gas is expanding and it is crossing the boundary, and work is also crossing the boundary. So you will ask that we should calculate the work using which formula? Integral PdV. So using PdV, we have to calculate the formula. But remember, this process is spontaneous process. It is not reversible process. That is why we cannot calculate work using PdV. That is why this process is shown. We have marked point 1, which is in equilibrium. We have marked point 2, which is in equilibrium. And between 1 to 2, we have dotted line. Dotted line means this process is not reversible. This is spontaneous process. We are removing the partition and gas is occupying the complete volume at an instant, spontaneously. Spontaneously this will occur. Okay, so this is the problem. That is why we have shown this by dotted line. Now see the diagram number 3. Diagram number 3, what we have done, again same volume is there. Okay, system we are considering only gas, there is a partition, and vacuum, inside vacuum we are adding infinite number of small partitions, infinite number of partitions. So it will be similar to the reversible process. We will remove slowly one by one partition. Now what will happen? We'll remove partition number 1, gas will slowly expand. We'll remove partition number 2, gas will slowly expand. So this is quasi-static process now. This is quasi-static and a reversible process. So here you can use this PdV work. You can use PdV work. Why? Because gas is crossing the boundary and work is also, work you can see, volume is expanding. Okay, volume is expanding. I mean gas volume. So now instead of dotted you will get dark process. But again in this case you cannot calculate work using PdV. The problem is the expansion which is done over here, it is against vacuum. In that case, this PdV work is not applicable. We require some atmospheric pressure on the other side. Okay. So again, there is one statement over here. Okay. In case of free expansion or unrestrained expansion or unrestricted expansion, work is zero. Okay, so here work is zero. Now we'll see, there is one more statement if you see in this case, is free expansion is a reversible, is a irreversible process. This free expansion process is highly irreversible process. So we'll see why this process is highly irreversible. So here you can see one two figures are given. So this figure indicates demonstration of the fact that unrestrained expansion or free expansion makes process irreversible. Why is this process irreversible? Again, this concept, it is a bit tricky to understand. Okay, so pay attention properly. So we'll see the same diagram again. So a volume is there and a partition is there, and we have gas and vacuum. Now suppose we remove the partition, what will happen? Gas will occupy the complete area, the complete volume, sorry. Now for process to be reversible, we need that the volume and we need the gas as it is. Okay, this is the initial state, and by reversing the process we again want this. So how this can be done? By compression. So what we will do in second figure, I have added here piston piston and cylinder arrangement. So this gas is compressed. Now whenever this gas is compressed, again what will happen, we will do the compression till mid part like this. So we'll get gas in this volume and this part will remain vacuum. But the problem is, this is not reversed yet. Why? Because of the compressor temperature is increased of the gas. So we need to reject heat from the system to the surrounding, so that this initial state and final state is same. Why? Because after compression temperature increases, but we want the temperature to be same as the initial state. So we will reject the heat. Now the problem is, when you reject the heat, in that case system is coming in equilibrium, but surrounding is not coming in equilibrium. Surrounding is receiving some heat. That is why this process is irreversible. Okay, see, even though system, see, what do you mean by reversible process? System should come to initial state as well as surrounding should come to initial state. So when we compress this, we can see volume, we are getting same volume. Temperature is increasing, so we are rejecting the heat. Now we will comment that system is system has been reversed exactly, but since this heat is rejected to the surrounding, surrounding is accepting some heat. So surrounding is not being reversed. So this process is not reversible. Are you getting? So system and surrounding both should be going back to the initial state. That is the meaning of reversible process. And that is not possible in case of free expansion. Why it is not possible? I have given example over here. Now apply first law of thermodynamics. So what you will get for a process, delta U equal to, so we are still in which process? Free expansion. Okay, so delta U equal to Q minus W. What is delta U? U2 minus U1 equal to Q1 to 2 minus W1 to 2. Now in free expansion process, we don't have work and no heat flows. So what we can get is, we can cancel in this equation, we can cancel Q, we can cancel W. So what you will get? U2 minus U1 is equal to 0. Therefore, for free expansion, you can write that U2 is equal to U1. And for ideal gas, internal energy is function of temperature. Why? Because U is Cv into T. So internal energy is function of temperature. So you can see, for an ideal gas or perfect gas, U is function of temperature. Okay, so U is function of temperature. That is why for ideal gas or perfect gas undergoing a free expansion, initial and final temperature is same. Okay, so two things you have to remember for free expansion. First thing is, work done is zero for free expansion. Second thing is, internal energy during free expansion of ideal gas remains same. That is why for ideal gas in free expansion temperature remains same. This is very important. It what is the condition for ideal gas only? This is important condition. So for ideal gas, initial and final temperature is same after free expansion. So you had asked me the question, right? Someone has asked me the question, after free expansion, won't the temperature reduce? So you got the answer. For free expansion of ideal gas, temperature remains same. Is this clear? No. What is the definition of internal energy? Internal energy, we have already seen the... No. See the definition. Wait a minute. See the definition of this. Okay. See the definition of CV. It is dou U by dou T when volume remains constant. So dU will always have CV dT. You can't take CP in that equation. And similarly, CP, what is the formula? Dou H by dou T when pressure is held constant. So always in dH you will have CP and always in dU you will have CV. So that is... Yes. And that is why for internal energy we use CV into T. So in this equation, you can refer the previous lectures. Everything is explained there. Okay, kindly go through the previous lecture. So that is why even if you remove the membrane over here, the gas expands. For ideal gas, temperature remains same. We just prove it over here. Okay, so temperature is remaining same. And work is zero. That we have seen by the logic. Okay, next part. Next part is perpetual motion machine of first kind. Okay, perpetual motion machine is a fictitious machine. Okay, it is a machine which cannot be possible physically. Okay, so we'll see what is the first law of thermodynamics. The first law states general principle of conservation of energy. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed during a process. It can only change forms. So there can be no machine which would continuously supply work without some other form of energy appearing simultaneously. Means what will happen is, if you see, I'll explain you this part. What is first law? First law is like we are supplying some heat. We are supplying some heat and we'll get some work. This is first law. Okay, so what is first law? Q is equal to W. This is first law. But what is second law? Q is not 100% equal to W. This we will see in second law. Why? Because some heat is, all heat cannot be converted into work. But first law, what it says? Energy is conserved, so heat is converted into work. But some energy is rejected. Okay, that part now we will see in second law. Actually, this heat and work is conserved. Some heat is rejected from the system. So if you add this heat plus rejected heat, then that addition will be equal to work. So Q equal to W will hold good. First law will always be true. Okay, so we'll see this part afterwards. So a machine which produces work continuously without any heat input. So this is a PMM1, perpetual motion machine of first kind, which is giving work without any heat. It violates first law of thermodynamics. It is a fictitious machine. Such a fictitious machine is called perpetual motion machine of first kind. So a machine which violates first law of thermodynamics is called perpetual motion machine of first kind. Now converse of this. What is converse of this? No machine which would continuously consume work without some other form of energy appearing simultaneously. What is meaning of this? So I'll explain you this. So this is a machine, suppose this is a machine, and this machine is consuming some work. So there will be some other form of energy which will appear simultaneously. you will supply work, that is not the only case. There will be some other form of energy which will appear in the system. So no machine which would continuously consume work without some other form of energy appearing simultaneously. Okay, this is converse of PMM1. Next, the last part of module number 1 is difference between heat and internal energy. Difference between heat and internal energy. So, we'll see this part. What is heat? Heat is a form of energy which is transferred. It crosses the boundary because of temperature difference. What is internal energy? Internal energy is sum of all microscopic form of energy of a system. Okay. What is heat? Heat is associated by a process. So whenever you see there is some process, there can be heat transfer. Okay. And what is internal energy? Internal energy is property of the system. This derivation we had already seen. That is why internal energy, it is not associated with a process. It is associated with a state. Heat is not a property. Internal energy is property of a system. Heat is path function. Internal energy is point function. Since heat is path function, heat has inexact differential. Internal energy has exact differential. Heat is recognized as boundary. Heat crosses the boundary. That is why heat is known as boundary phenomena. Internal energy is a system phenomena. System does not possess heat. Heat is only transferring. But system can possess energy. Heat is a form of energy which is not stored in the system and is viewed as a dynamic form of energy or energy interaction. Whereas internal energy can be stored, contained or stored in the system and viewed as static form of energy. So this is the difference between heat and energy. We'll quickly summarize what we have seen in module number 1 till now. Okay, so this is the last part of module number 1. We'll go through what we have studied, what all topics we have covered. So we have seen thermodynamics and its importance. Then we have seen macroscopic and microscopic viewpoint, continuum, system surrounding boundary, types of system, control system, it is also known as control mass, it is also known as non-flow system. Next we have seen open system, it is also known as control volume or flow system, isolated system, then thermodynamic equilibrium, two types of property, intensive, extensive property, what do you mean by state, path, process, cycle, point function, path function, quasi-static process, it is also known as reversible process, then moving boundary work, it is also known as PDV work, zeroth law, energy, sources of energy, forms of energy, free expansion, which we have seen today, flow work, ideal gas, specific heat, internal energy, first law of thermodynamics for a cycle. Now there is some limitation of first law of thermodynamics that we will see in next lecture. Why we require second law of thermodynamics, that we will see at the beginning of module number 2. Next topic which we had seen was first law of thermodynamics for closed system undergoing a process. So this was the formula which we had seen was delta U equal to Q minus W. This formula we had seen. First law for isolated system. Then we had seen internal energy, a property of system, and perpetual motion machine of first kind. Then for open system, what we had studied? For open system, what we had studied? We'll quickly go through that part as well. So for open system, we had seen what is steady flow process, what are the examples of steady flow devices. Then we had derived steady flow energy equation, we had seen assumptions. We applied steady flow energy equation for nozzle. Diffuser you can apply, I had not applied it. Then turbine we had applied, compressor we had applied, boiler and throttling device. We had seen Joule-Thomson coefficient, porous plug experiment. Then we had applied steady flow energy equation for heat exchanger. Then after that we solved three numericals. After solving the numericals, we studied the concept of integral minus VDP. Okay, we had studied the concept of integral VDP, this part. How that equation is derived. And then after deriving the equation, what we had done, we had applied the integral minus integral VDP to various processes. Constant volume, constant pressure, isothermal, isentropic and polytropic to calculate work. And after that, we had created a final table for work transfer formula. So work transfer for closed system or non-closed system, these are the formulas. Work transfer for open system or steady flow system is minus integral VDP. We had derived these formulas. After that, we had seen free expansion. In free expansion, work is zero and free expansion is expansion against vacuum. And then we had seen why free expansion is irreversible process. Then for ideal gas undergoing free expansion, temperature, initial temperature and final temperature remain same. This we have derived. Again, see this type of question, it is asked in competitive exams like GATE. Okay, these small questions are asked in those type of exams. Then we had seen perpetual PMM1, perpetual motion machine of first kind.